Yeah, once this template is set up, this is by far the fastest and probably the best way to track out all your different tracks on the MPC all at one time. The MPC One has 8 virtual outputs, so you can record into your DAW up to 8 mono signals all at the same time, or 4 stereo signals. What we're doing is taking our DAW's virtual multi-channel outputs of a track, and we are routing them to other tracks in order to record all the tracks inside your MPC and your MPC software all at one time.
And knowing is half the battle.
Okay, so I'm using Reaper for this example, but you can really use any DAW for this process. So let's load up the MPC software.
Later.
Okay, so we got to do 2 things really. We got to tell Reaper how we want to track this out, and then we got to tell the MPC how we want to track things out. Okay, let's start out with the software here in Reaper. What we're going to do is right click and this option right here, build multi-channel routing for output of selected effects. And then I'll ask you if it wants you to do all this and just hit yes. Okay, so what Reaper did was,
it's supposed to be good for you.
Make a bunch of other tracks, which has the output already routed to them with different channels of output. The first one is channel 1, 2, and then we have 3, 4, 5, 6, so on and so on. Okay, next what we need to do is set up the MPC. And for me, the easiest way to do that is with the hardware or the controller. So let's take a look at that.
I'm not gonna try it, you try it.
Okay, so what you want to do with your project pulled up, you want to go to Track Mix, and then you want to go over to this page here, Route, and I'm going to leave my drums here on 1 and 2, then I'm going to take the next track, and I'm going to put it on 3 and 4. And you can either use the wheel here, or you can click here and open up this page and you can select it here, but I like using this. So next track, we're going to go 5, 6, then we're going to go 7, 8, and finish up with 9, 10. Okay, let's play that back in Reaper and see what that does.
We'll return after these messages.
This is starting to be fun.
Okay, as you can see, it's playing back in different tracks. We have output 3, 4 here. We have 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, 10. And so let's solo 1, 2. And we have just the drums. Let's solo the next one. And the next one.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
And so what that allows us to do is just hit record and we can record all the stems all at once. Let me see. This is a 6-beat loop. Let's see, let's go like this. On the MPC, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna play it one more time. I'm gonna let it loop around one time completely, and just before it loops around, I'm gonna hit record.
The noise.
Okay, just a couple last things to set up here in Reaper.
What's going on?
What you want to do is select all the tracks that you're going to be recording on. And you want to record arm them. And you want to select the inputs and make it none. And then you want to right click the record arm button. And you want to select record output. And we'll do record output stereo. And what I like to do is let it loop around one time before I hit record, and when it's almost at the end of the loop, I hit record. And I let it play all the way around and just past the end of the loop before I hit play again and stop the recording. Okay, let's give that a try.
You try it.
And so, like I was saying, we're going to let this loop around, get to the end of this loop here. We'll hit record, record it on through, pass the loop one more time, and then we'll stop playback. And here we go. And the reason I like to let it loop around when I'm using hardware is to kind of let everything sync up. Sometimes it doesn't always start right in sync, so it's a good idea to let it loop around. There we go. And we're going to save all. Okay, so let's also set this up as a template that we can use next time, and it won't take us long to set up every other time we want to use this process. We'll just have it as a saved template.
Wait, what? Why don't we?
Oh, never mind.
So the very first thing I want you to do is go ahead and save at this point.
Guys, the pain is almost over.
Okay, and then what I want you to do is turn off all these record arm buttons. All right. And then this is the part that's going to freak you out. I want you to highlight everything you just recorded and delete it.
What's going on?
I also have some tracks up here. I'm going to delete those. And then right now at this point, we're going to save this as a template.
He likes it. Hey, Mikey.
I'm going to go to file. Oh, let's see. Project templates, save project as template. And I think I'm gonna call this MPC MU multi audio. And it's got in project templates, save. And then I'm gonna go and undo two times so I can get my tracks back.
That's good enough for me.
We'll be back right after this message. Stay with us.
And everything's back how we had it. Okay, the last thing that you may want to do once you have it saved as a template is just delete all these extra tracks down here if you don't need them. Yes, delete. All right. All right, well, I hope this video was helpful for somebody. And keep in mind, you can also use the same technique if you have other hardware pieces of gear that have multiple outputs, whether they're physical outputs or virtual, as in how we used it with the MPC plugin, you can use the same kind of technique to record everything all at the same time.
That's it. No more.
So, I hope that all of you have a good one, and until I talk to you next time, remember to treat all your people really well, because life is short. Have a good one.
Here is Jennifer McLogan, NBC News.
With his hair.
Spoiler. Spoiler alert. Spoiler alert. We are. Spoiler? Wow, what a weird word. Spoiler alert. Alright, spoiler alert. We are not going to. Son of a bitch.